HPV vaccine is still cloaked in controversy 15 years after its debut. In fact, a new study found that thousands of social media posts like these are going viral and driving people's fear and decision not to vaccinate. Joining us to weigh in on this topic is OBGYN Dr. Thais Aliabadi. So Dr. Aliabadi, what goes through your mind when you hear that these posts are driving people not to vaccinate?
The problem with the internet and with social media is basically social media is where people express their personal experiences, their stories. It's not based on any scientific data. And I think we need to, everyone needs to be more aware of this. And when they want to search any medical topics, it's important for them to use, you know, accredited websites and make sure not to follow these stories and people's personal experiences when it comes to this important topic.
So Dr. Offit, I personally believe that we're in the middle of an infodemic on top of the pandemic because misinformation spreads so quickly. And we know how media contagion works. You hear one personal story and it essentially overrides all the statistics and maybe medical reports that you've been reading. So how are you convincing parents that vaccines are safe? And in this case, this is necessary for their children and their teens.
So what you do for people, I think, who are scared because of what they read, they smelled the smoke, they want to know whether there's any fire there, is you try and say, look, what is it you're worried about? And then you can say, look, here's how you would answer that question. You know, you look at people who got the vaccine or didn't get the vaccine and then see whether that thing you're worried about is more common in that group. And if people are susceptible to logic and reason and data, then I think you can convince them. But I think some of the anti-vaccine activists really are just largely conspiracy theorists. They don't believe any of the data that you tell them. And as Neil deGrasse Tyson says, if you come to a conclusion without using logic or reason isn't going to talk you out of it. And I think that's the frustration.
Let's talk about the impact of these so-called Gardasil girls. I mean, it's almost unbelievable what zealots they are in regards to the HPV vaccine.
No, and that's what the anti-vaccine people did. They got a group of adolescent girls together who told a compelling story about how they were fine. They got the vaccine, and now they have chronic fatigue. They have chronic pain. They can't get out of bed. They were previously star athletes or star students, and now they're not that anymore. And people are very much compelled by that. But when you look at the data that shows that, you know, that's not true, you know, you're really working against the emotion with statistics, which is really hard. I had to go to Japan, actually, within the past year and a half, and the Gardasil girls were there. They went from immunization rates of close to 90% in Japan to less than 1%. And I had to speak in front of a large group of Japanese physicians, and I said, you would just condemn 2,000 people, children, to grow up and die from a vaccine-preventable disease, from vaccine-preventable cancer. You don't know their names, but they have names. And if I gave you their names, I suspect you would vaccinate them to make sure that they didn't get that disease. But see, it's done anonymously. You don't know who those people are. And it was really hard to watch that.